We have 8 nominees and 2 bills. 5 of the nominees listed for the first time will be held over at the request of the minority. Eunice Lee, 2nd Circuit. Veronica Rossman, 10th Circuit. 3 nominees to the Western District of Washington: David Astudio, Lauren King, and Tana Lynn. We're going to consider those nominees after we return from the break for the 4th of July. We will vote today on 3 nominees: Margaret Strickland for the U.S. District Court in New Mexico. She has a distinguished career and criminal practice as well as civil practice, which is great. She served as a public defender and civil rights attorney. Also, she has worked in areas of civil practice in the private side, so her breadth of courtroom experience is remarkable. She has tried approximately 90 cases. There are few people in America can say that. And the vast majority of her practice was taking place in federal courts. The ABA says she is well qualified, and I think she'll do a great job. David Chipman is nominated to lead the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Firearms, Explosives, better known as ATF, 25 years in law enforcement, the vast majority with ATF. Special agent, he witnessed firsthand the real danger that gun crime and illicit gun trafficking posed to communities, and the dangers they particularly face people in law enforcement because of this. As a result, as a responsible gun owner who's advocated for common sense constitutional gun safety measures, as someone who's worked to bolster health and safety for law enforcement, Mr. Chipman is uniquely positioned to restore both credibility and accountability. This is a test. This nomination is a test. Can we put someone in charge of the ATF? You know, it's been 6 years. No one's there because we couldn't reach an agreement on any person. I hope we can reach an agreement that Mr. Chipman is the right person at this moment. Ms. Jaddou is nominated to head the U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Service, USCIS. Has almost 20 years of experience in immigration law and policy. She would be the first woman to serve in that position. She's well qualified for it. Sorely need experience and competent leadership there. She is the daughter of immigrants from Mexico and Iraq. Ms. Jaddou began her career working on immigration policy and oversight for 9 years in the House. She later served as chief counsel at USCIS, and as chief counsel, she managed more than 200 attorneys supporting the work of that agency worldwide. The American Federation of Government Employees National Citizenship and Immigration Service Council 119, the union that represents over 13,000 employees there, specifically highlighted this in their letter of support, saying she's well acquainted with the operations of this agency. We also have 2 bipartisan bills on the markup agenda that are interesting and have some controversy to them. A bill I'm co-sponsoring with Chuck Grassley on cameras in the courtroom related to the Supreme Court, and a bill that Senators Grassley and Klobuchar are bringing before us called Sunshine in the Courtroom Act. As we approach the end of another Supreme Court term, many of us have been intently watching the news for updates on latest decisions. While we may disagree on how the justices decide a case, I hope we can agree that it would be healthy for our democracy for the American people to actually see the court in action. That's what's behind this bill. We worked on this on a bipartisan basis, and I hope we can pass both of these bills today. There are a number of amendments.